Hey everybody, I'm Bo from the product design team at Wrike.
And I'm Jill, one of our enablement program leads. Today, we're excited to walk you through the key product updates for 2024. This was an incredible year for us here at Wrike. Our product and engineering teams worked tirelessly to bring exciting new innovations to the market.
Absolutely. And last year we released 134 of them. And a bunch of those, 35%, were in direct response to your feedback. And I'm talking about our customers. I'm not talking about you, Jill. Considering there were fewer than 250 working days, our teams were really pumping out some value this year.
Let's break down the biggest launches, starting with Wrike Work Intelligence. Features like AI content creation, AI editing, and AI summaries are helping our customers save so much time. Personally, I find AI content editing super useful because I use it almost every day when I type comments. I usually type way too quickly, so all I have to do is click that magic AI button and boom, all my typos are fixed.
For sure. Personally, I love AI comment summaries. I'm always getting looped into these crazy long conversation threads with zero context. And honestly, fair enough. Who's got time to get me up to speed when AI can do it in seconds? So it's been a massive time saver for me this year. Another huge new capability is Datahub, which is our data management experience. It spent some time in labs, but as of October, it's officially live for everyone. It made a big splash when we announced it was available at Collaborate 2024. In case you haven't heard, Collaborate's our annual conference where we share tons of product updates, best practices, customer stories, and so much more. It's so much fun and brings tons of valuable insights. Keep an eye out for the Collaborate 2025 announcement later in the year. And definitely check out how it went last year by following the link in the description. Back to Datahub. We've taken data integration to the next level with this tool. We've all been there, clicking through multiple tabs trying to find a source of information. Imagine being able to integrate all your business critical data directly into your main work environment, where all your work flows. Now you can connect your external data with Wrike projects and tasks to create a single source of data embedded in Wrike. If you want to explore more, check out the Datahub feature page. We'll leave a link in the description below.
Now let's dive into some exciting updates to team and user management. We've introduced handy timesheet approvals to streamline and simplify the approval process and ensure secure, accurate time tracking. Timesheet submission rules to ensure accuracy and compliance. Custom fields in user profiles, also known as attributes, are now available to help track key details, manage resources, and make task assignments easier than ever. But finally, the new file lock features prevent unauthorized edits or deletions, giving your team more control over shared files. And who doesn't need more control? We're bringing resource management, time tracking, and project execution into one cohesive platform. Not only that, but we're confident that these updates will be especially helpful for professional services teams who work with clients on everything from concept to billing.
Here's one that's gotten a huge response from our community. New dashboards. All last year, the team was churning out some solid gold updates. And I've got to take a deep breath because there are so many. So here we go. Pivot tables that let you see your chart data in a tabular form. A calendar widget so you can view your items in a layout like calendar view. No more switching between tabs. And speaking of widgets, we also added an activity stream widget and files widget that's got mass editing, drag fill values, and Excel export. User count metrics and a display as option. Sections for organizing widgets. A notepad widget and link navigation. And AI-powered widget creation.
We've worked really hard to deliver these updates, and we want to say a huge thank you to you for sharing your feedback with us. Your input not only motivates us, but also helps shape the direction of our features.
By the way, new dashboards have been available for just under a year, and already over 80% of our customers are using them.
And let's not forget about our end of year announcement about Klaxoon.
Yeah, and I can't wait to annoy you, Jill, and our other colleagues with my doodles and stick figures.
Well, I think we can do a little bit better than doodles and stick figures with Klaxoon. But with Klaxoon, you'll be able to auto-create real projects and so much more. During Collaborate, we showcased a visual collaboration demo. So if you're curious about the practical side of this functionality, please be sure to check it out in our product keynote. Just keep in mind, this is our vision for the future, and we're working hard to make it a reality soon. We'll leave a link in the description for the details on the Klaxoon acquisition, along with instructions on how to navigate to the demo. By the way, if you're interested in learning more about Wrike plus Klaxoon Era, join our upcoming webinar on February 13th. You can also find that description in the link below.
That's awesome, Jill. Visual collaboration was probably my favorite moment from last year's Collaborate keynote. Now, let's shift gears and talk about the updates we delivered this year on the mobile front. We've continued to invest in our mobile apps because we know that having quick, seamless access to your work right from your pocket is more important than ever. So here are some highlights. Gen AI features are now helping you generate comments or summarize threads directly from your mobile app. Table view allows you to edit status, assignee, start date, and due date fields, and display items grouped based on your desktop settings. Dashboard improvements make it easier to stay updated on work insights, pin commonly used dashboards, and share links, all on the go. Calendar support lets you access and manage calendars directly from your mobile app and keep you on top of your schedules anytime, anywhere. Board view lets you manage tasks on Kanban boards right from your mobile device. You asked, we delivered. We're committed to investing in Wrike's mobile experience, and as always, we're listening to your feedback to make it even better. We want to remove all barriers to working on the go.
Now to request form updates. Since most work in Wrike starts with a form, we made that process even easier too. We released customizable email confirmations for external request forms that let you personalize sender details, email content, and even branding. Time constraints for form questions to help prevent form fillers from selecting a due date earlier than specified, as well as the ability to use workflows from different spaces in request forms. And last but not least, Datahub users can now link Datahub fields to request form questions.
Those are great updates, but my favorite, and I'm not just saying this because I personally worked on it for most of the last year, is dark mode. That's right. The release so many of our customers have been waiting for. You don't have to be blinded by a bright white Wrike anymore. That should be welcome news to everyone who's doing their time in the dungeons of media production and to all the night owls out there.
Night owls? I thought you were a part of that team.
No, actually, I'm up super early. You can see I work in this really bright environment, but I live in the UK. It gets dark early here in the winter, and when it's not dark, it's raining, which means I get a ton of use out of dark mode.
Safe to say, it might be your favorite release that we had last year?
For sure. All those updates were super exciting, but I'm honored to wrap up our 2024 recap digest with improvements to our core view, which is obviously table view. This is the go-to view for so many of our users, so we've put a lot of effort into improving not only its performance, but also its functionality. Some of the major updates this year are public links, which make sharing tables so much easier. You can now mass enable project progress, which saves you a ton of clicks. And based on your feedback, undo and redo are back. And that wraps up our major 2024 product updates.
Wow, that's so much. Truly impressive.
I couldn't agree more. And those were just the major ones. We've also delivered over 100 additional updates across the product, from enhancements to the calendar view and proofing tool, to UI improvements, performance optimizations, and so much more.
Absolutely. It's been an exciting and productive year for us, and we hope that with all of these new additions, you'll find even more ways to make your work life easier and feel that much more productive.
Totally. That's the vision we're bringing to life, a world where everyone is free to focus on their most impactful work together, a world where work flows seamlessly.
Well, thank you all for staying with us. And on behalf of the entire Wrike team, we wish you an even more exciting year ahead.
And thank you for watching. Head over to the comments section and share your favorite updates in 2024. And if you like this recap, subscribe to our channel for more on Wrike.